Hi friends, welcome to the channel. Today's topic is strain gauge and load cell. Today we will try to understand what is strain gauge, load cell, what are its constructional details and also the operating principle. Okay. Coming to the strain gauge is a sensor which converts a force, pressure, applied pressure and tension or a weight into a resistance. Whenever a pressure is applied or pressure is applied over a strain gauge, it experiences tension and compression. Okay, see here, tension and compression it will experience. Okay, now we will see what exactly happens. If a tension is experienced by this strain gauge, that will cause the increase in resistance, and the compression experienced by the same strain gauge will cause the decrease in the resistance. Now we will see how tension causes increase in the resistance. Already we know the concept that a resistance is given by R is equal to rho L by A. Rho is a resistivity, L is a length of a wire, and A is a cross-sectional area of the wire. Okay. Whenever tension is experienced by this strain gauge, what happens? So tension will increase the length. So you can see the tension means, so it is along XY axis. In that way, in that axis the wire length will increase. Okay, that's what. If tension is increased, then L will increase, cross sectional area will decrease, which result in this expression as a R increases. So that's what, the tension caused by the applied force will be increasing the resistance, and the compression you can see here. Okay, R is equal to rho into L by A, and once here you can observe, just a second. Here you can observe that L is decreasing. Okay, whenever a compression is happening, L is decreasing and A is increasing, which results in R is decreasing. Okay, so this is what exactly, how exactly the strain gauge is operating. Okay, so applied pressure or applied force over the strain gauge experiences tension and compression, and the tension causes the increase in resistance and compression causes decrease in the resistance. Here some statement is there, like bounded strain gauge. There are two types of strain gauges, bounded and unbounded. For our example, we will be considering bounded strain gauge. Okay, so next we will see what exactly happening with respect to load cell. Actually, load cell is used to it is a device used to measure the weight of an object. Okay, and it uses strain gauge as a elements. Okay, so what exactly strain gauge is doing? Strain gauge is experiencing the exerted force and converting it into a resistance. But load cell, what exactly it is doing? Load cell is used to measure the weight of an object, and that measurement is to be in the form of electrical signal. Means load cell uses a strain gauge. Strain gauge converts exerted applied force into a resistance, and that resistance will be converted back to electrical signal in the load cell. Now there are two types of load cells, like beam type of load cell and column type of load cell. What exactly happens in beam type of load cell? So in case of a beam type of load cell, it looks like this, and one end is connected to a rigid support and another end is kept hanging, wherein I'll be applying the exerted force. Okay, so in the column type of load cell, what happens, this spherical load bottom, so over which we will be applying the load. Okay, so it is along horizontal axis. Okay, like this, over the spherical bottom. So here it is over this hanging portion we will be applying the force, which is to be measured. Okay, so that's the thing, where exactly we will be keeping our force to be measured for the beam type and column type. Now in case of a beam type, what exactly the structure is? Actually, in this beam type, you can observe that there are four different strain gauges are kept. You see here, this is first strain gauge, second strain gauge, third strain gauge and fourth strain gauge. Okay, over the hollow tube, above hollow tube there are two strain gauge, below hollow tube there are two strain gauge. You can see here there is a spring material is available in this, at this end. Okay, and this is connected to rigid body, that's what, there is no movement at this end, and there is a spring is available at this stage, there will be a hanging motion, like moment is there, okay? So that moment is converted into a resistant, and then it will be converted back to electrical signal, okay? So this is how exactly the construction of beam type of load cell is. So coming to here, it is a column type of load cell. You can observe it is a cross-sectional area of this cross-sectional diagram of this load cell. So in this you can observe that there will be a spherical load button, so wherein we will be applying our load to measure the weight of an object. Okay, now there will be two types of two different diaphragms are available. Okay, between them there will be a hollow tube, and there will it is covered by it is complete this load cell is completely covered by housing filled with air gap. Okay, you can observe that this is your exactly strain gauge where you will be placing. Okay, so above that means before that wherever the applied force is there, before it go to strain gauge, it will be going to the elastic body. So that compression and expansion of that electric body will be giving you the changes in the resistance by the strain gauge. Okay, so this is what exactly what will be the constructional detail of load cell, and how exactly the strain gauges are placed in the load cell. Now we will see how column type of load cell works. Okay, so this is a column type of load cell. It's very simple to understand. You will be applying your load or your force along the S axis, okay, and compression is experienced by this steel bar. And when you will be applying your force from top to bottom, what happens? Yes, this strain gauge will experience, yes, strain gauge B will experience increase in the resistance. In the same way, strain gauge A will experience decrease in the resistance. Why? Already we have seen how exactly the strain gauge operates. Okay, what happens in the compression, what happens in the expansion or a tension. Okay, so means whenever a force is applied, it will be compressing along S axis and expanding along A XY axis. Okay, so that result into increase in strain gauge A resistance and decrease in strain gauge B right? Okay, so fine, now we will try to go for how exactly that means. I'll be going for one animation. You can see here applied force, how exactly it is changing the strain gauge dimensions. Okay, this change in the strain gauge dimension will result into change in the resistance. Now we will come to beam type of load cell. How exactly it is operating? It is very simple. One end is connected to rigid support. Okay, another end is hanging, and that hanging end is having a spring. Whenever you will apply certain force here, so or certain pressure here, at that time it will move like this, right? Okay, you can observe there are four different strain gauges, like 1, 2, 3, 4. So here also there are four strain gauges. Okay, when you will apply any force here, this strain gauge experience compression, this strain gauge experience tension, this strain gauge experience compression, this strain gauge experience tension. Okay, now we will see how exactly it is structured in the form of a bridge network here. So you can observe what exactly happening in the last diagram. Yes, I'll be applying a pressure here. So these yellow colored things are actually the strain gauge. After I'm applying the pressure, what is happening to the strain gauge? Okay, this is experiencing compression, this is experiencing tension, this is experiencing compression, this is experiencing tension. So this resultant compression and expansion results into a change in the resistance. That change in the resistance you can feel here. Okay, so I'll take this once again upper side. Okay, the change in the resistance you can observe here. Okay, so now just a second, you can easily observe here. Now just a minute. Now it is showing the change in the resistance. You can observe previously all the resistance is 350 ohm. Okay, but when a pressure is applied, it is converting into 349 or 350.7, like that. Initially all are same. Okay, after applying the pressure, the resistance is going to change. Okay. Some people may be asking like why this bridge network is coming into picture. So we will have that after some time, just a minute. So is it, I feel it is clear to you how exactly this is, this last diagram is working. Okay, fine. So now we will look into how exactly the resistance is converted into an electrical signal. So we will see here. So here we will be having a additional circuitry. You can observe here also, here also. There is an additional circuitry along with strain gauge. Okay. See, this strain gauge is connected here, right? Okay. Whenever the pressure is applied, what is happening? In this bridge, only this strain, this resistance is variable. All the other resistance are fixed. So this change, this variable resistance is experiencing due to variation applied force. Due to applied force, the resistance is changing. Okay, that is reflecting in this needle. Okay, that is reflecting in this meter, you can say. Okay, so this is what exactly how weight is converted into resistance. Now, here we will try to understand why we are keeping a bridge network. It's very simple. If we take a bridge network, sensors adopt, sorry, which sensor actually? Strain gauge kept in a bridge network. Okay, if we have a strain gauge kept in a bridge network, what is the advantage we are getting? We are improving the sensitivity of a load cell. Okay, we are increasing the sensitivity of the load cell. That's what we are keeping the strain gauges in the bridge network. Okay, so you can see here this change in the resistance is very small. So that's what I would like to change, collect all the changes in the resistance whenever a force is applied. So that will improve the sensitivity of the strain gauge. Now we will come to the applications. No doubt it is used to measure the load of an object or a weight of an object. So you can see this can be used in a grocery shops. It can be used in the cranes. It can be used in the weighing machines, like you can measure the very heavy weights, like weight of an object, weight of a bus, car, like that. So there also we will be using the load cell, and this is also one of the load cell application where we will be using. So this is what all related to strain gauge and the load cell, how exactly it is operating, and what is the constructional detail and what are all the applications. Thank you dear students, for your friends, for your patient listening. So we will see the next video with the next sensor. Thank you for your patient listening.